Hello, everybody. Welcome to Grove Junior High, your home of the Elks, as today the 7th graders take on the Holmes Hawks. And now let's meet the visiting Holmes Hawks. They are head coached by Justin James. And now let's meet the visiting Hawks players. Number 5, James Pasterski. Number 15, Ryan King. Number 21, Nick Torax. Number 23, David Ziba. Number 32, Mike Petraris. Number 33, Jacob Ludolph. Number 35, Dim Miftari. And he's really tall, by the way, if you didn't get the hint. Number 40, Eduardo Padilla. Number 42, TJ Hayes. And number 53, Gabe Reyes. And now let's meet the Grove Elks. Introducing the head coach first, John Prusco. And now let's meet the players. Number 1, Bryce Hannon. Number 4, Ryan Steffens. Number 10, Sean Martinez. Number 14, Christian Pang. Number 15, Bradley Simmons. Number 21, Evan Walsh. Number 22, Zach Eugene. And number 44, Eric Borsch. And I see number 23, there's a misprint on here. So Dylan Hood, thank you. All right, gentlemen, best of luck. Show some great sportsmanship and let's play some basketball. Well, now that we got that misprint out of the way, welcome to another presentation of Grove Junior Elk Grove TV. Excuse me. We are here at Grove Junior High School, the home of the Elks, as they take on the Holmes Hawks today. Holmes Hawks in the visiting black jerseys with white trim and red numbers, and the Elks, the home team, in their green jerseys, white trim and gold numbers. As I mentioned, the head coach, who has been on our broadcast before on some occasions in the past, John Prusco, coaching the 7th grade boys today. And Justin James, head coach for the Holmes Hawks, taking his squad here to Grove Junior High today. Eric Borsch will be at the tip-off for the Elks. And the big guy, number 35, Din Miftari, at center. And I noticed we don't have any referees yet, however. So we can't start the game until we have an official. So we might want to have to wait just a minute before we get the officials out on the court. And both teams are going to go to the respective benches right now. We might have started just a minute too early here. You know what? It's always fun here at Grove Junior High. You never know what to expect. You know, there's always a lot of fun here. So we will wait just a minute before we get our officials to come out to the court. Our cameramen today, Sean King and Rick Signorella, putting on a fantastic job once again today, as always. I think they might need the both of you to go out there and officiate at this point. I don't know. So we wait for the officials. As I mentioned, John Prusco has been on the broadcast a couple of times before with me as a color commentator. As he coaches some of the younger grades here at Grove Junior High, he's talked with me about, you know, just playing simple basketball, to-the-point basketball, if you will, you know, just making the good, simple passes and just letting the flow of the game come to the players and not necessarily the players coming to the game. As it appears we still don't have an official, as Coach Prusco just came out from the hallway. And, well, I would say maybe the snow could have been an issue, but it is sunny outside today for the first time in as many days. So the players might actually maybe want to have another warm-up in before we get this started today. As it appears, some of the conversation might be for the kids. What are they going to have for dinner at this point? As they have a little time to kill. I'm Ryan Fahey with you here on the broadcast today on this presentation of Elk Grove TV here at Grove Junior High here in Elk Grove, Illinois. As even Coach Justin James of the Hawks is, we're all having a nice chuckle about this, that the officials have yet to arrive. Maybe the parking lot's full, I'm not so sure. Hope they didn't double park anybody, then we're going to have to call a tow truck. And as we are going to wait for the officials, we will take a short timeout. And as soon as the referees come out of their tunnels, we will get this game shortly here. So we'll be coming right back here on Elk Grove TV. All right, so we're going to have some replacement refs. And no, they are not the NFL kind, folks. You can't write this stuff. So we're going to have one of the former, one of the basketball coaches here as well, who has been on the broadcast, Brandon, here as well. We have another official as well at midcourt, and his name is John. So we have John and Brandon as our officials for today's matches. We don't know what happened to the other refs. So here we go. Once again, to tip it off, it'll be Borsch and Miftari at center court. Hawks going right to left, and the Elks going left to right to start. 6 minute quarter, tip off, and here we go. Tip off controlled by the Elks, and it's Zach Eugene to bring it up for the Elks. Going through the paint, trying to shimmy-sham away in for a layup. Has the handoff there as that one tops off the board. She couldn't get the layup, though. Rebound by the Hawks, but almost a quick turnover, and it ends up being a turnover as we have 14 seconds into this game. Into the far corner now, it goes number 23, Dylan Hood. And now in the corner, it's Pang trying to save it, cannot, as he lost that one out of bounds. It'll be Hawks ball, 5:36 to go in the first. And now it's Jacob Ludloff to bring it up the floor for the Hawks. Now the far elbow, it goes to number 21, Nick Torres, shot up there, off the back of the rim, no good. Rebound by the big guy, Miftari, and in. He is taller than a lot of people here in this building today, and he's using his size with great ability, 2-0 Hawks. 5:18 to go in the first quarter. Elks would now have the near elbow to the near quarter. It's Christian Pang putting up the 15-footer, no good, off the far side of the rim. But the offensive rebound controlled by the Elks towards the top of the key, back to Pang. Pang now trying to go inside with a can. They go back out to the far elbow. And the left-handed dribbler in Zach Eugene going around to the baseline, trying to put up a floater, no good. And that one goes back to the corner. Pang tries to save it. He does. Pang trapped in the corner, gets the ball out. And rotating towards the top of the key now will be Ryan Steffens. 4:48 to go here in this first quarter. 2-0 Hawks with the lead. Trying to go inside, putting up the shot there off the front of the rim, no good, was Eric Borsch. Another offensive rebound for the Elks as they try to sell it down out of the far elbow. Christian Pang looking to go inside. Back out again towards the top. And with it now is Eugene going to the baseline, back out to Pang. Thought about the shot, and he'll be called for a travel there. He picked up his pivot foot. 4:25 to go here in quarter number one. So the Hawks inbound it and will bring it up the floor. Jacob Ludolph again, and a bad pass. They're taking away, and here come the Elks on a fast break. They might have a two-on-one, and up for the layup just underneath that one. Got ahead of himself there with Zach Eugene. And the Hawks get it back. Play now goes up and inside. Bad pass out of bounds. And the ball will stay with the Hawks as it was last touched by the Elks. So it's in baseline inbound underneath the hoop. Play now inside to the near corner. Switching it around there is Torres. Now rotating inside to the big guy. Miftari, and he puts that one in. And he's got the Hawks 4 points so far in this first quarter. 4-0, 3:53 to go in the first. Pass down to the far elbow, it's Pang in the corner. Pang now goes back out now to Zach Eugene, trying to drive inside, but kicks it back out to Pang as he tries to bring it back out towards the top of the key and does. Bad pass trying to go inside, but right back to him there was Ryan Steffens. Shot up off the back of the glass, no good. Good shot opportunity though by the Elks. Still have yet to capitalize, 2 minutes and 30 seconds in. And now for the Hawks, going inside again, it's Miftari trying to put up the bank shot, no good. Controlled by the Elks, trying to bring it up on a fast break. No, they cannot. And a quick steal, and a quick layup is up and good there from the Hawks, and Jacob Ludolph, 6-0. And now the Elks driving through the paint, and he lost it off his own knee. Can't Hawks, the Elks bring it back. It's Pang, trying to go inside, but can't. Stolen away there by Torres. Torres tries to bring it up on a fast break, picked from behind. And it's Pang to bring it up, and off to Zach Eugene it goes. Zach Eugene trying to go to the baseline, and we got a foul, a bump call there And that will go against the Hawks, in particular, that'll go against Mike Petreras. And we have a hockey-like line change here, as we have four new Elks coming into the game. Evan Waltz is one of them, along with Bryce Hennig. And we'll get to some of the other guys in just a second as the play is inbounded from underneath the hoop. As up for the shot from the baseline, off the top of the backboard, no good. Quick turnaround, offensive rebound opportunity. Couldn't be capitalized there, as it was Sean Martinez who just checked in as well on that. It's Eugene trying to float one up, blocked away there by Fumitari. And a scramble for the ball, jump ball is called. Possession arrow goes to the Hawks, who still have a 6-0 lead here in this first quarter with 2:36 to go. And now for the Hawks, bringing it up is Nick Torres. Torres now with a nice little crossover there at the top. Now to the near corner, thought about the shot, fakes it, takes two steps, pulls up for another shot there. Jacob Ludoff makes it 8-0. Bryce Hennig now for the Elks. Gives out to Zach Eugene at the near elbow, trying to go inside to Martinez. Goes now, cross-court pass to Simmons, trying to rainbow that one up, and it's saved in play, but the Hawks take it away. And that's going to be a travel, as trying to bring that one up there was number 33, Jacob Ludoff. Took that extra step, can't do that. So the Elks will inbound it from underneath their own hoop. Sean Martinez to inbound for the Elks. And he just gets it in. And out of the near elbow it is to Bryce Hennig to rotate around. Now it's up for the jumper off the front of the rim, no good there by Bradley Simmons. And almost a quick turnover again from the Hawks, but they bring it back up the court now. Minute 53 to go in the first. Ludoff inside to Miftari. Off the glass, no good. Own rebound again, trying to bank it off the glass again, no good. Two misses in a row from Miftari, trying to save it in bounds. Look out there, and they do. Good hustle there by Gabe Reyes, and that was deflected into the backcourt, so the Hawks pick it up. Ludoff rotates around now to the top of the key, and that'll be a two-pointer for goes, no good. Miftari trying to get the rebound, but could not. Rebound goes to the Elks and Hennig. Hennig now to the far side corner. Trying to get it towards the top. The Elks go inside. Back out Martinez. And no call there. They let that one go. And a jump ball's caught as there's a scramble for it on the ground. Elks will keep possession. Three new Holmes Hawks check into the game now. As Miftari will take a seat. And Du Miftari is probably taller than everybody else here in this building today. As the inbound now for the Elks to the far elbow. It'll be a three if it goes. Goes over the backboard out of bounds. So that'll be Hawks ball with a minute six to go. 8-0 Holmes. Jacob Ludoff with it now as we approach the 1 minute mark to go here in this first quarter. Having this one and going up with it there and getting the layup. David Ziba, who just checked in just a moment ago, and makes it 10-0 Holmes. And now it's Eugene. Now to the far corner, bad pass just over the head of number 15, Bradley Simmons. It's Hawks ball, 46.6 seconds to go. Ryan Steffens checks into the game now for the Elks as Zach Eugene takes a seat. 43 seconds down to go here in this first quarter. 10-0 Holmes with the lead. Now to play there towards the free throw line and almost trying to do an ankle breaker, cannot. And that's a travel call there as trying to pick up his dribble. They're trying to pick up his balance, for that matter, was David Ziba. Or they're actually going to say, but they changed the call. My apologies. They're going to say it was a foul there, a little trip call, if you will, which ensued that travel. 35.2 seconds to go in this first quarter. Inbound pass goes down to Ziba, trapped in the corner. And a pickoff steal there as taking that one up is Evan Walls. Walls going inside, nice pass off the glass, just off the front of the rim, no good there. Was number four, Ryan Steffens. Quick fast break opportunity for the Hawks. Two-on-one passing off the glass. Just too strong there from Ludoff. But he does get his own rebound with 15 seconds to go. So it looks like the Hawks might try to hold it for one final shot. And into the paint, stolen away there. And a scramble jump ball called. It'll stay with the Hawks. 6.8 seconds to go. So it's a 10-0 Hawks lead right now over the Elks here at Grove Junior High. And here comes the inbound underneath the hoop with 6.5. That was tipped, and a quick fast break opportunity now for Ryan Steffens as the clock tries to expire. Off the glass, no good. Just too strong on that one. And a lean leg Kareem attempt at the buzzer, no good. And it will stay 10-0 Hawks as we go into the end of the first quarter. So a dominant first quarter by the Holmes Hawks to start, and we'll see how quarter number two will go for the Elks in just a couple of moments here on Elk Grove TV. Welcome back for the second quarter now as the Elks trail 10-0 to the Holmes Hawks. It's Elks ball to start the second quarter. 6 minutes on the clock, and here we go. It's Ryan Steffens with it, trying to go inside of Martinez. High pass, but he corrals it. Nice job done by Martinez to keep it in play. Pass going in the paint, stolen away there. Bad pass from Steffens as the Hawks will bring it up. It's TJ Hayes with the ball now. Hayes now to the near quarter, turns around and gives that one now off to number 40, Padilla. Quick floater up off the back of the rim, no good. Rebound by Martinez for the Elks to bring it up. And now with it, Bryce Hennig. And that'll be a bad pass again off the out of bounds, Hawks ball. Remember the last time having John Prusco on the broadcast, who was coaching the Elks here today, talked about simple basketball, making good passes. For his team, not so kind of the start he wanted, as we've seen a lot of turnovers on the side of the Elks as they get that quick turnover there as the missed shot by the Hawks turns into an Elks possession now. Quick jumper there off the back of the rim. Friendly bounce not working for Grove Junior High either as Martinez tried to save that. Look, got into the corner there. It'll be Hawks ball. 5:08 to go here in the second quarter. So it's David Ziba. Ziba will bring it up with his left hand. And he gives one this one now to Padilla. Pia now going cross court. As the Elks are trying to build on their, or trying to come back from this 10-point deficit they are facing with 4:50 to go here in the second quarter. It's Ziba with the floater, no good. Rebound controlled there by Bryce Hennig. Hennig now trying to hustle up onto the far side, trying to go inside but can't. And another bad pass off of a possession from the Elks turns into another Holmes possession. And now it's Ziba running around with it, and a clean deflection there off the Elks as they bring it back. Here comes Bradley Simmons now to the near side. Simmons trying to float one up from the baseline, no good. Seems like the Elks are trying to rush a lot of their plays here in this first half so far. Not getting as many set plays as Coach Prusco would want. And a bad pass there from the Elks turns into a turnover. 2-on-1 opportunity here. As now it's Martinez. He's going to pull up for a three. Off the front side of the rim, no good. Second chance opportunity. And what happens when you get a second chance opportunity? It's another chance to score. And that's the first field goal for the Elks as they're now down 8, 10-2, with 3:50 to go in the first half. TJ Hayes now. Looking to go inside. Back rim shot, no good. Rebound control by Martinez. And a bad pass there as it went right to Eduardo Padilla, who I don't even think he saw that pass coming to him, but he caught it anyway. Ziba now with the floater, side of the rim, no good. Gets his own rebound, and he will dribble this one out to reset. It's a 10-2 Hawks lead. Ziba gets the ball, front of the rim, no good. It's batted around and picked up there by Steffens. Steffens down to the near side, he's bumped. And they are gonna say it was not in the act of shooting, so they will inbound it from underneath the hoop. As we have four new Elks coming into the game now. Eric Borsch checks in, along with Christian Pang. Zach Eugene also into the game as well. Along with Dylan Hood. Inbound now goes to Pang. Pang out of the near corner. As that one batted away, Ziba trying to house the foot, and it will go out of bounds. It'll be Hawks ball, last touch by Christian Pang. With 3:15 to go here in this first half. So it'll be inbounded right in front of us here. And now it's Hayes getting it off the inbound, who gives it off to Ziba right away. Ziba now to the far wing, rotating towards the top. Ziba, now back to Padilla, drives in, floats it up, back of the rim, gets the friendly rolling in. And the Hawks still in control here in this first half, up now 12-2. Zach Eugene brings it up, trying to cross over for a layup, and he gets fouled in the act of shooting, so we'll see our first free throw opportunity of the game so far by the Elks and Zach Eugene. He'll go to the line for two as they are down 12-2 with 2:55 to go here in the second quarter. And off the front of the rim, no good. He misses the first one. We'll get a second one coming up. Off the side of the rim, no good. He goes 0 for 2, but an offensive rebound there by Dylan Hood. As Pang trying to get the ball, but could not. Wide open, Zebra on the breakaway. Foul, count the bucket. Zebra there with a quick hustle there off the steal. Runs it up for the layup, gets hit from behind. And he goes to the line for the and one as the Hawks now up 12, 14-2, 2:47 to go in the first half. So Zeba at the line now to shoot the and one. Off the front of the rim, no good, and it hits off of Pang out of bounds, so the possession error will stay with the Hawks. Not everything is not going the Elks' way so far. A couple bad deflections, and no luck off the backboard or rim for the Elks in this first half, which is why they only have one field goal so far in this first half. Hayes with it now, and it's a quick steal there by Christian Pang, as a little full-court pressure being shown here by the Hawks. And now it's Zach Eugene to bring it up. Eugene looking to go behind him, but cannot. Stolen away there by Padilla as he got it off the quick bounce. Jump ball possession, and the arrow will stay with the Hawks, so they will inbound it to bring it up full court now with 2:30 to go here in the first half. And now it's David Zeba. Zeman now gives it to Hayes. Hayes looking to go into the paint, trying to float one up. And a quick pass and a foul there on Pang. So Ryan King will go to the line to shoot two now. King now out the line for two to try to extend their 12-point lead. And now it's 13. Nothing but net there. 15-2 Holmes with 2:21 to go here in the first half. Evan Walsh checks into the game now, along with, for the Hawks, Jacob Ludolph. So Ryan King at the line for one more free throw to try to make this a 16-2 Hawks lead. Trying to bank it in, but cannot, and the ball goes to Eugene. He's trying to run it up for a two-on-one, passes it up to Walsh, lays it up just a little too strong there, and it's not saved in play, though, by Eric Borsch. Couldn't control it. Out of bounds. Hawks ball. 2:12 to go. And now coming up with this one now, as is Du Miftari. And he's going to be called for a travel, as he is not too happy with himself about that one. So Penguin inbound it now to Zach Eugene. And Eugene brings it up for the Elks as we approach the two-minute mark here to go in this first half. Borsch with a one-touch pass inside. As the shot there, no good. Rattles around, and the Elks keep it. As the Hawks didn't settle that one down. And now it's Borsch. Has that one stripped away there from Padilla. And Padilla will bring this one up now to Ludolph. Ludolph looks around, gives it back to Padilla. Now at the top of the key it goes. Now to Torres. Torres' shot was blocked on the play. And we got a loose ball foul against the Hawks. So it'll be Elks ball with 100 seconds left to go here in the first half. So here comes Zach Eugene with it, and we get a whistle, and we're going to have a substitution as a late one, if you will, as it's Gabe Reyes into the game now for the Hawks. Eduardo Padilla takes the seat. So off that substitution, we get back to play. Zach Eugene to bring it up, and a quick jumper there from off the just off the edge of the paint there, and good. The second field goal of the day for the Elks, and that one will be credited to Evan Walls. 15-4 the score. Holmes still with the lead. Minute 20 to go. And with it now is Ludolph. Now it's King. Working it around to the near corner. Jumper, nothing but net there. Nicely done there by number 21, Nick Torres. 17-4 Hawks. Eugene runs through it. He's trying to do the underhand. No good. And this one will hit off of Ryan King, I believe. And it'll stay Elks ball with exactly 1 minute to go here in the first half. Christian Pang winbound it from underneath his own hoop. Pang Walls floats one up and in. So that's 4 points for number 21. 17-6 now the score. Hawks with the 11-point lead with 50 seconds. Ludoff now. Working baseline, far side, inside to Mivtari. And he's going to be hit from behind on the arm. And he'll go to the line to shoot two. Not sure if it's the Hack-a-Shack approach, but nonetheless, Mivtari at the line to shoot two. 44.2 seconds to go here in this first half. Holmes Junior High with a 17-6 lead. Mivtari with a line drive free throw shot, no good. He gets one more. Second one is up, off the back of the rim, no good. Rebound by Walls. As there's 40 seconds left to go, as he kind of seemed like he lost control of the ball as he was throwing it. He gets it back, shoots it up off the glass, no good. And rebound, we're going to have a jump ball, and it will stay with the Elks. 31.7 seconds to go here in the first half. It'll be Zach Eugene inbound from underneath his own hoop. And he goes down to the far corner and Pang with 30 seconds left. It's Hood with the jumper now, and he floats one in. Nicely done there by Dylan Hood, as it's now only a single-digit lead for the Hawks. 17-8 with 18 seconds to go in the first half. Ludoff. Ludoff now working around to the far wing. Kicks it out now to the corner. And the three-pointer is no good, as that one is last touched off of Hood. With 7.2 seconds left, inbounding this one will be Gabe Reyes. Mivtari trying to put up a shot, and we get a foul there from Evan Walls on the floor, so it'll be another inbound play coming up. 5.8 seconds left to go in the first half. 17-8, the Holmes Hawks have the lead over the Grove Elks. Once again, it's Reyes to inbound it. And now it's Ludoff at the top, looks up at the clock, 2 seconds. And it is a foul there against Zach Eugene. And as they always say, never foul a jump shooter when there's only a few seconds left. So Jacob Ludoff at the line to shoot two with 1.1 seconds left here in the first half. And the one-on-one opportunity, no good. Mivtari at the buzzer, yes. Good awareness there, good offensive rebound by Mivtari. And going into the half, it's the Hawks 19 and the Elks 8. And we'll see if the Elks can turn it around in the second half. Coming up in just a few minutes here on Elk Grove TV. Welcome back here to Grove Junior High, the home of the Elks, as we get ready for the second half between the Grove Elks and the Holmes Hawks. The Hawks have the 19-8 lead as we begin the second half. Nice job there by the Palms and Cheerleader squad as they provided our halftime entertainment. And we finally have an official in the zebra uniform here today. We were waiting for one at the beginning of the game. We had Brandon and John step in to start, and now we have our third official here in a zebra uniform to get things started for the second half. Hawks ball, they're the road team in the black jerseys, and the Elks the home team in the green jerseys. Hawks are going left to right, and the Elks going right to left. 5:55 to go as we just got in the third quarter underway. And now it's Zach Ujame bringing it up now with a quick layup off the left-handed side, up and in. And the Elks now only down 9. They've been down by as much as 15 at one point in this game. So they're looking to come off the second start hot and ready to go and get back into this game. It's TJ Hayes trying to lob that one up. He does. Quick shot up there, no good, and trying to hustle for that one. And getting that one is Gabe Reyes. He gives this one out to Ziba, rotates around into the paint, kicks it back out and out to Hayes. Hayes now inside, nice pass, up for the layup, just a little too strong on that one. There was Mike Petraris. Quick offensive rebound by Reyes, trying to put up a shot, no good. And the rebound by Ryan Steffens. Steffens sells it down at the near elbow, going inside now to Borsch. Now back out, now it goes. And it's Dylan Hood for that one, and no good. Jump ball, possession arrow will go to the Hawks. Or my apologies, it's going to stay with the Elks. 5:05 to go here in this third quarter. 19-10, Hawks with the lead over the Elks. Inbounded now to Steffens. Steffens to Borsch. Borsch with a shot that did not hit the backboard. And he knew the second he threw it up, he wasn't happy with it. So, but it was deflected, so it will stay with the Elks. But nonetheless, not the best shot opportunity he could have had. And a bad pass there as that one's taken away there by David Ziba. He hustles up the court with the layup. Too strong, Borsch with the rebound. And a bad pass there. Hawks pick it up. And it goes back now to TJ Hayes. As that one is off the hip, no good. That is number 53, Gabe Reyes. He puts that one up and in, 21-10. Zach Ujame quickly back now. And that'll be a blocking foul there on the Hawks. That's against Mike Petraris. Zach Ujame inbounded from underneath his own hoop. And now it's Christian Pang with it now at the near corner. He'll bring this one to the elbow. Now back to goes to Ujame. 4:25 to go in the third. Ujame driving baseline, trying to. Kicks it back out to Pang. Pang now rotates towards the top. Looking to find somebody but can't. Goes to Steffens, back to Ujame. Zach Ujame trying to go baseline again. Goes back to Pang at the elbow. And that one goes over the hands of Steffens. That'll be an over and back. So it'll be Hawks ball with 4:07 to go in the third. Gabe Reyes will inbound it now to Ziba, who did not see the pass coming. He was not paying attention. And that one is going to be a foul there against Ziba, trying to reach in for that one. So the Elks will inbound it from underneath their own hoop once again with Zach Ujame to inbound it. He gets it in the board, trying to go back into Ujame quickly, but it was not executed well enough. As the Hawks now have it with 3:57 to go. Full court pressure by Ujame with the steal. Too strong on the layup. Reyes with the board. And a quick, nice pass up. Nobody was there. And the layup is up and good there. Nicely done by Mike Petraris. 23-10, Hawks with the lead. Zach Ujame and a reaching foul there on Ziba. Ujame was stripped, trying to go inside the paint there. So the Elks swim on it from right next to the scorer's table. And they bring it up. Inside now to Borsch. Nice pass to Pang, looking for the layup. Off the front of the rim, no good. And the rebound is controlled there by Reyes. And that one they're taking up. And it's Steffens with the steal. And Christian Pang ends up with it. And now that one goes to Ujame. Bad pass there. And that one is deflected off Ziba, who was trying to go for the steal. So it'll still be Elks ball as we have, oh boy, a lot of substitutions. We've had the entire benches come to the court, and now the court go to the bench. We'll have to get this settled in just a second. Bryce Hennig's into the game, we know that now. Zach Ujame also probably the only one that stayed in. It's Bradley Simmons who gives that one to Hennig, back to Simmons. Simmons in the corner from about 12 feet, no good. And Ryan King with the rebound. We'll assume he checked in, as it looked like there were too many players coming in and off the bench. With a running floater, almost nicely done. Mavtari, he is reaching over like a tree branch to the grass. And he'll be, I don't know, they might call that a bear hug foul, actually. I don't know if you want to call that a reach in. That's more of just a bear hug. Can't necessarily do that in basketball. 2:50 to go. I guess it's nice with the Elks references to trees, as that bank shot is in there from Sean Martinez, and it's now 23-12. Elks trying to show a little full court pressure here, as bringing this one up is Nick Torres. Now it's Martinez, and they're going to say Martinez stepped on the line. So the Hawks will inbound it from the corner here. And Padilla trying to inbound it. He lobs it up. Stolen away there by Evan Walsh. And Walsh trying to bring it up. He was hit from behind. He tries to save it, but they're going to say he was out of bounds going for that ball with a Dennis Rodman-esque steal attempt. Hawks have the ball 23-12 with 2:25 to go in the third. And now it's Ludoff. Ludoff looking to go around with it. And a timeout's going to be called by head coach Justin James, as he kind of saw that his players were getting a little pressured in the backcourt. So with that timeout, we will take a short break and come right back. 23-12 Hawks with 2:18 left to go here in the third quarter. Back off that Hawks timeout now. 2:18 to go here in the third quarter. Brandon pulling double duty here today, making sure the kids get to the buses and officiating this game today as well. It's always an interesting experience every time we're here at Grove Junior High, in a good way, of course. I want to thank everybody here at Grove Junior High for allowing us to come here and help broadcast these games here on Elk Grove TV. So we definitely want to show our gratitude towards them. So as we'll get the inbound done shortly, as the Hawks break from their respective huddle. 23-12, the Holmes Hawks have the lead here over the Elks with 2:18 to go here in the third quarter. It'll be Padilla to inbound it, and he gets it into Ludoff. As they look for the double team, Walls with the steal there. Walls trying to do the bounce pass inside. Padilla read it nicely, and he's double teamed to the backcourt. He gives it to Ludoff, and he'll try to hustle it up with numbers. He goes to Mavtari, throws up a shot, no good. And saving that one is Eugene, as this one now is up to Simmons. Bradley Simmons trying to hustle now to the far side. Put up a layup too strong. Martinez trying to put it back, no good. Up with it now is Hennig. Off the backboard, no good. Another offensive rebound. And Martinez's shot was no good. Martinez wanted a foul, didn't get it though. And now inside Mavtari, turns around, no good. Mavtari wanted a foul. He's not too happy about that one. He thought he was fouled. Walls now to the far side. Simmons is now up for this one for three. Trying to bank it in, no good. Rebound Martinez. Bank shot, good. And now the Elks deficit is nine. And Padilla saying get open. Can't blame him, and a bad pass there. Turnover, Simmons puts it up. He's fouled. He'll go to the line and shoot two. What an eventful last 30 seconds here of this game, so Simmons goes to the line to shoot two now. As the Elks down nine with a minute 11 to go here in the third quarter. Simmons at the line for two. Simmons, first shot no good, and it appeared that Nick Torres thought it was a bonus attempt, so he'll just go right back to where he'll be stationed, in between the red hashes. And Mavtari takes a seat, so it might be a plus for the Elks considering his size has been all up in the paint. And it's gonna be a loose ball foul against the Elks, so it'll be Hawks ball with a minute 10 to go in the third. Padilla now trying to inbound it to Ludoff. He does. Ludoff trying to run up with numbers, but can't. Ludoff now to the far wing. Rotates towards the top of the key. And that one is hit off of his own shoe. And they're going to say it was deflected, however. And now we get a foul against Bryce Hennig. 56.8 seconds to go. Padilla to inbound it. Padilla inbounds that one. Bad pass. Walls with the turnover. He might have a 2-on-0. Walls with the easy layup. And he does not get the friendly roll off the hoop. And we got a whoa, look out there. As Ludolph was almost thrown to the ground there by Zach Eugene. But it will be Hawks ball with 49 seconds to go in the third. Ludolph now with it. Full court pressure being shown by the Elks. And no foul called there, as they're going to say it was a clean reach-in attempt. So it'll be Elks ball with 43 seconds. Zach Eugene on the near elbow, switching to the corner. Now it's Martinez trying to go inside but can't. Now it's Simmons. Block shot attempt there by Ludolph. Good defense, but it goes back to Martinez. Martinez is going to go inside to Eugene. Reverse layup, no good. Martinez just ran his way for that rebound. He's going baseline with it now. Trying to do a reverse layup, but he will be fouled on the play going up for that layup, so he'll go to the line to shoot two. So it's Sean Martinez at the line to shoot two. And he misses the first one, but he has one more coming up. And we have just found a second Striped Zebra official, by the way. More on this in a minute. Martinez, the second free throw, no good. Rebounded there by King. He tries to lob it one up, and it is a jump ball. Possession arrow will stay with the Hawks. And now it's Ludolph. With 11 seconds to go, bad pass stolen by Sean Martinez. He looks to control it. Ooh, nice crossover there, going up for the layup, floats up too strong. Rebound Simmons, no good. And it's Martinez again as he tries to throw it up with the buzzer, but cannot. And that will end the third quarter. Elks showing some life. Can they continue in the fourth quarter? Find out next as they're down 9 here on Elk Grove TV. And we're back here now for the fourth quarter between the Holmes Hawks and the Grove Junior High Elks here on Elk Grove TV. Hawks have a 23-14 lead as 6 minutes put on the clock for the final quarter. So it'll be Elks ball to start here for this fourth quarter as they're down 9. As they're looking to rally to try to get back into this game and be having their deficit be less than 9. Quick shot up by Borsch. Back of the rim, no good. Rebound by Mivtari, but it goes right back to Borsch. Free throw, jumper off the glass and in. And that might be the start that the Elks were looking for, as they're now only down 7. And now it's Zeba. Falls down on his own. Timeout quickly called there by head coach Justin James and the Hawks with 5:39 to go, as we've only played 21 seconds of this final quarter. I want to thank our camera guys today, Sean King, Rick Signorella, for putting on a fantastic production as always. Sean King down on the court, Rick Signorella right next to me to my right, putting up with my craziness as always. 23-16, Hawks have the lead here over the Grove Elks with 5:39 to go here in the fourth quarter. The bonus in effect for the Elks, just to keep in mind, the 1-1. So off that timeout now, it will still be Hawks ball. Right at about the mid-court line by the scorers table. And now it's Zeba with it. Zeba dribbles that one off his knee. That's could be a costly turnover down the stretch. So remember that in case the Elks are to score here. And now inside it's Borsch. Goes back out. That one will be deflected, and it will stay with the Elks. That'll be Hennig to inbound. He inbounds it out of Christian Pang. Pang now goes back towards the top of the key with it, and it gives it to Ryan Steffens. Steffens now to Hennig. Hennig going inside to Hood. Hood floats one up, but it's blocked by Mivtari. And Zebra trying to run with it, and a reaching foul there as going on the fast break there for the Hawks was Zebra. So he will inbound it. Or not he will. I will say it's Gabe Reyes to inbound it right at the midcourt line. And Reyes looking to find somebody. He does. He gives that one out to Mike Patras. As this one now is to Mivtari. Must have kept his pivot foot. They did not call a travel, and he puts up a nice layup. 25-16 Hawks. And he's trying to run the fast break. He does not want to go into the paint, fearing of the block. As he misses that one, Zebra picks it up. Zebra has that one poked away. Scramble for the midcourt. Christian Peng trying to get it. Can't. And up with it now is Petraris. Layup rolls in. 27-16. And a bad pass. Is it kept in? No, it is not. As Stephens trying to hustle for that one, could not. So it'll be Hawks ball as they're up 11, 4:39 to go. It's Zebra now to the far corner, driving baseline, floats one up and in. David Zebra making easy work of that one, and the Hawks lead now up to 13. Now it's Pang in the corner. Trying to go inside, can't, and he throws that one out of bounds. But they're going to say it was deflected. Yes, it was. It's Pang, and now it goes to Hennig. And now it's Borsch at the free throw line jumper, trying to bank it in, no good. Rebound by Petraris. And that one will be wrestled by Borsch. Jump ball, possession arrow will go to the Hawks. And he slams that one with frustration. And we get a whistle and a... Ref's just convening to make sure they have everything settled correctly on the floor. They do. Now it's TJ Hayes with it. Hayes trying to go up with it towards the front court. He almost loses it at the scorer's table, and he does get it in nicely. It's a 3-on-1 layup, no good, and it hits off of Matari's foot, and he is not happy with himself about that one, trying to get the offensive rebound. Now the Elks bring it up with just under 4 to go, and it's Steffens. Steffens rotates around to the baseline, far side, throws up a wicked shot, no good. And that one will be picked up there by Petraris. And a quick steal as Pang came in from out of nowhere. Christian Pang will be fouled on the play there by Mike Petraris. It's a on-the-floor foul, so it'll be a baseline inbound. Looks like we'll have a few substitutions now for the Elks. Or no, he won't actually. So look at this, actually in the act of shooting. At first they were going to inbound it, so it'll be a 1-on-1 free throw coming up now for Pang. Off the back of the rim, it's a live ball, and it's rebounded there by Mivtari. It's Zebra bringing it up. Almost lost his dribble, floats up a shot, and nothing to it for David Zebra, who has been having a great game here today. 31-16 Hawks. It's Hennig. He throws that one right to TJ Hayes. And that one is quickly turned over. Borsch picks it up. He threw that thinking somebody was down there, as there was nobody home. It'll be Hawks ball. And here come four new Elks. We have Sean Martinez into the game along with Evan Waltz, Zach Eugene, and Bradley Simmons. Bradley Simmons with the orange and red shoes, but with purple socks. He hits that off the front of the rim, no good. And fouled there was Eric Borsch by Mike Petraris, it appeared. And now we're going to see five new Hawks players come in. So we'll get this settled in just a second. Jacob Ludolph into the game, along with Eduardo Padilla. Ryan King also in there. And we'll get to some of the other ones in just a second. There's Borsch now at the 1-1. He tries to bank it home, cannot. Picked up Martinez, easy layup for him though. So he turns one free throw into 2 points off the layup. 31-18 the score. 3 minutes to go in the game. And Zach Eugene with the quick steal, all alone to the hoop. He tries to lay it up and in, no good. Simmons rebound. Short on that one. Eugene gets it back to Martinez, and Eugene is fouled as he was trying to get the pass to Martinez. So it'll be a 1-1 once again for the Elks, and it's Eugene at the line. He makes it. We'll have a second free throw. If he misses, it's a live ball. And it's a live ball, and it's picked up by the Hawks. It'll be Ludolf now with 2:47 to go as his team's up 13. And it's picked off there by Martinez, all alone to the hoop. Too strong on the layup, picked up Eugene, he gets it in. 31-20. Elks won't go away quietly. And now it goes up with that one, and they might have numbers down the court as that one, there was Nick Torres, and he lost his dribble there. Jump ball, no. Ludolf comes up with it, and Walsh trying to go for the steal. It'll stay with the Hawks. Underneath their own hoop, they will inbound. Eduardo Padilla to inbound with 2:15 to go in the game. And now it's Ludolf, and that one's picked off by Zach Eugene. He's tripped from behind. So it'll be, once again, they're going to say it's a two free throw shot. They're going to say it was in the act of shooting. So we will see two free throws here, according to the official. So Eugene at the line to shoot two, down 11 with 2:10 to go. First free throw rolls around and in. Now David Ziba checks into the game. Nick Torres will take a seat. Zach Eugene with one more free throw. And it's good. That striped zebra official I told you about, he's actually a wrestling official in the field house. So there's the update on that I said in the third quarter. And a quick wrestle stolen away there by Martinez. He throws up a wicked pass, and that one is volleyball swatted away like by David Ziba. Probably the best thing he could have done there, actually, to get that one away. So we'll stay Elks ball from underneath their own hoop with a minute 58 to go, down 9. Martinez now puts up a shot. A little too strong on that one. Hawks let it go as it's their ball. Now Padilla inbounds it. He's looking for somebody. And Walsh trying to come from behind, but it will stay with the Hawks. Padilla now gets it into Ludolf. Ludolf looking to go inside. And it's Ryan King trying to go for it, but Cam Martinez with the steal. Gives this one to Zach Eugene, losing control, trying to save it in bounds, could not. It'll go back to the Hawks. 102 seconds left to go here in the game. That's a minute 42 for those who might aren't official with the seconds part of it, as Evan Walsh with the steal misses the layup. As the Elks are trying to show some full court pressure here, as it's Ziba now to the top of the key to Ludolf. Ludolf. It's Padilla now, and that one goes deflected to Ziba off the front of the rim. No good, rebound by Walls. And he gives it to Zach Eugene to bring it up. 75 left to go in the game. Simmons hits one up, and he is fouled there on the shot. But they're going to call it, I believe, a 1-1 opportunity. So if he, once again, if he makes it, he gets a second. If it's a miss, it's a live ball. And he will get a second one. End of the game now for the Hawks is number 32, Mike Petraris. Ryan King takes the seat. And the second free throw is an air ball. So that'll be an automatic change of possession as it goes now to the Hawks with a minute 11 left. And a quick pick away there from Martinez, but it will stay with the Hawks. There's only 2 seconds. We're off the clock there. Minute 9 left. That one is into Ludolf, who almost had that poke from behind, but it brings it up instead. And coming up with that one, layup, no good. And scramble for it there, and it was hit off of a Hawk there, so it'll be Elks ball with exactly 1 minute to go in the game. And the Elks and head coach John Prusco call a timeout as they are down 8 with 1 minute to go. And we'll see if they can rally up something here in the final 60 seconds here on Elk Grove TV. All right, we're back in off that Elks timeout as they're down 8 with a minute to go. Let's see what Coach Prusco for the Elks draws up here in the final 60 seconds of the game, down 8. It'll be Zach Eugene inbound. And it's Walls with it now. Back to Zach Eugene at the top. It's Martinez. Walls pulls up for 3, and he banks it in. And now they're only down 5, 31-26. 45 seconds to go. Padilla trying to inbound it, and he does to Ziba. And a travel's gonna be called there. Wait a second. The Elks down 5 with 40 seconds to go. Sean Martinez quickly wants the inbound, and here we go. Zach Eugene with the ball at the corner. He puts up a 3 off the front of the rim, no good. Ludolph with the rebound, and a foul there. And that will go against, I believe, Eric Borsch. With 34 and a half seconds left. That'll be Padilla to inbound it for the Hawks. Inbound to Ludolph. It appears they're just going to try to trap Ludolph if they can. And a block foul will go against Martinez. 29.6 seconds to go. Ball be inbounded right near the midcourt line. And Padilla looking to inbound it. He's trying to find somebody. He does. And he finds Petraeus. The trap trying to be set there. And turning around. No good layup there. Rebound Ludolph. Hit from behind. And a jump ball possession. And it's Elks ball. 19.6 seconds to go. They've got to hurry it here. Zach Eugene. 16 seconds. Simmons. Rainbow 3. In and out. This place was going to go bananas if that happened, but he gets his own rebound. Simmons turns around. Not a waltz. 6 seconds. He senses the urgency. Tries to throw up a wicked 3. Cannot. And Martinez went to the ground hard. And he's a little slow to get up. But he appears to be okay, which is a good thing. Only a second and a half left. A great effort, though, from the Elks here today. They did not show any quit. And they showed some sparks here in this second half. Padilla needs to inbound it, and it looks like that'll do it. And it will. Even with the late rally at the end, it was not enough. The Holmes Hawks come into Grove Junior High and get the 31-26 victory here over the Elks. So for our guys Sean King and Rick Signorella, I'm Ryan Fahey signing off on the broadcast. This has been another presentation of Elk Grove TV.